Hi, I'm Mandy Hellenius, president and co-founder of the Da Vinci Initiative, a nonprofit foundation that supports K-12 art learning. Today I want to talk to you about how to do a still life setup in your classroom. If you look at the drawing to my right over here, you can see that there's a very clear light source, and sometimes teachers have a hard time controlling the light in that manner in their own projects in their classroom. So I've developed a few ways to help you teach these types of still life projects in your classroom, because it's such an essential skill for students to be able to observe something very carefully that doesn't move, to help them improve their own visual literacy. So controlling light in a classroom can be difficult because sometimes you have many different light sources. You have overhead lights, you have windows, some of you don't have any windows. So there's a variety of lighting situations. So what I found is really helpful is to control the light using a shadow box. This is a shadow box design that I've developed for K-12 art teachers. It's made of foam core. What it is it's an L shape that's been scored on two sides and reinforced with some duct tape to act as a hinge. And then on the top here is just a small piece of Velcro that holds the whole thing together. And so in a very short period of time, you have something that stores very flat into a shadow box. So you can see that already this is blocking light from two directions. For some of you, for example, in this film setup, we have a lot of light coming from this direction as well as from above in many different directions. So if you have really random light sources that are coming from a lot of different directions, what you can do is create an entire shadow box by stacking two of these on top of each other so that you can control the entire lighting situation and block out light from all angles. For your light source for this setup, what you can do is, I got these clip-on lights from the dollar store that turn on and off. So what you can do is just clip this light to the side of your shadow box here, you know, tilt it to your preference, and you can use any kind of objects. I recommend using white objects for students who are starting still life for the first time, because it's easier to see light and dark values on these objects. This is a ping pong ball. I got, you know, like 30 or 50 of these for just, you know, maybe $10 or so. Kind of clicking, just sticking this in here. I've put a piece of kneaded eraser. You could also use a piece of tape just to keep it from rolling around. So you can stick these in here. These buckets I got 3 for a dollar, also at the dollar store. And you know, all of a sudden I have both a cylinder shape and a sphere shape that my students can practice their drawing and form drawing with. So this whole setup, I recommend having two students work from one box. I know some of you have 35 or more students in your public art classrooms these days. So having two students per box, make sure that you aren't using up more table space than you have. And it also keeps your costs down for making these boxes and setting them up in your classroom. So, you know, this box, I can make two boxes for a $1 piece of foam core from the dollar store, plus this $1 light and a ping pong ball or whatever other objects you want to put in. So it's a very economical way to include still life into your curricula. Okay, so here is a still life setup that is easy to do. When the students are done, they need less than a minute to tear down their still life setup, turn off their lights, unhinge their boxes. And these boxes fold one direction, so they collapse pretty narrowly. And when they are collapsed, they take up hardly no space. I should mention that if students are going to be working from the same still life for several days in a row, you can take a piece of white chalk and just mark the still life objects where they land on here, and that way they can have a really quick tear down and set up every day. Most of you are probably working with 45-minute class periods, so we don't want to waste all that time setting up and tearing down. So it's just a really quick, easy way to control your light, have your students do a quality still life project, and make sure that they're working on art for the longest period of time within each class period. So you know, we can collapse these down, stack them up in the corner of your classroom, and you have a great setup going on for your students. Great. Well, my name again is Mandy Hellenius. I'm with the Da Vinci Initiative, www.davincianitiative.org. You can find detailed lesson plans about how to do a still life drawing in your own classroom, and also very detailed lesson plans on how to create this box yourself. So you can have your students make them, or you can make them yourself, but all the information you need is at www.davincianitiative.org.